All right, yo, so this is Datamag 2018 or Datalynx Magnus coming at you with an unboxing. We are looking at the Combatants Fight for Glory series by XesRay Studio, brand new company. Nobody really knows anything about them. It looks like they're basing their stuff off of the gladiatorial arenas in Roman times. And these things are hot right now. So I wanted to check these out. I'm a big Mythic Legions guy, but as everybody knows, if you follow Mythic Legions, they're getting really expensive on the secondary market. So if you don't get in on the first, you know, pre-orders, you're paying 50, 60, 70, 80, sometimes hundreds of dollars for figures. And it's getting really out of control, honestly. Now, these aren't cheap. They're not, you know, Marvel Legends price. But, you know, they're 50, 60 bucks a guy. And, you know, for that price, you expect to get some good quality. Thankfully, these are good quality. So I'm gonna run through each of these guys real quick. This is just really a quick unboxing. It's not a true review per se, but I just wanna get some more information out there on these figures. Cause I know a lot of people are wondering, is it worth it? Should I pony up the money for it? I got mine from Empire Toy Shop. So I'm pretty happy that they got here quick and that I can take a look at them. And then I can give you guys some, you know, opinions about them. I mean, so far I got them open and they look and they feel awesome. I can't wait to take some pictures of them with the Mythic Legions and maybe get them in some stop motions. So let's look at each one real quick and then we'll talk about the set overall. All right, so first up, we're going to look at Branthok. Nicknamed Devilfish, ethnicity Germanic, city Pompeii, group Marcellus. That group, according to the bios, and I'm not going to read the bios, but I read them earlier, and they have kind of a very Spartacus slant to them, where these guys have a Lanista, and a Lanista is a person who basically runs a gladiator school. So each of these guys have a certain Lanista that they work for, that they are slave to, that they fight for, and they've been fighting each other in different arena battles. So this first guy is Branthok, and he is a gladiator from the Germanic tribes. He's got some cool armor on one arm. He's got some cool shin guards. And he comes with the accessories of, he has a net, and those of you that maybe haven't watched a whole lot of gladiator films or haven't watched that Spartacus show, which I do recommend, there's a certain fighting style as far as the gladiators go. And come to find out, there was dozens of different styles or different kind of, I don't know, schools of training for different types of fighting styles in the gladiator arenas. And certain styles would use certain weapons or wear certain types of helmets. This style would use the net, almost like a fisherman's net, and this pitchfork type thing. So this is what he uses. This is what he's known for. And we'll get a quick look at him. Very excellent sculpt on these guys. I mean, their face sculpts are awesome. Musculature, anatomy, very good. And all the bodies are the same as far as like articulation and stuff. So you got a really good ab crunch there. There is only a single jointed elbow, but it does get really good range. Honestly, that's a lot better range than a Mythic Legions. And you have good leg extension there for splits. Your knee is double jointed. And then you have a very familiar kind of setup for your ankle. Very similar to a Marvel Legends or something like that. I think it's called a forward facing pin. so you can get rocker and all that other stuff. Your shoulders are on a ball joint, but it's a kind of a different kind of ball joint than maybe your Marvel Legend. You don't have a bicep swivel, but you have a swivel at the shoulder. And then you also have a swivel at the elbow, which I forgot to mention. Your neck is on a ball peg. It looks like it might be a dumbbell peg, like a ball inside the neck and inside the head, but you can get good tilt. You can look down pretty good. And his up is not great, but it's decent. And one of the big draws for these figures is that they're modular. You've seen Unparalleled Universe's review. I'm not gonna do this, but he took off all the armor off every single figure and was able to swap them back and forth. So that is a big draw for these. Kind of just like Mythic Legions, but you know, different kind of style. A lot more articulation. Look, I'm not about to sit up here and say that they're better than Mythic Legions, but the added articulation is definitely a strong suit. Next we have Kanuba, nickname Hyena. Ethnicity from Carthage, city Neapolis, group Calidus. Got a scale mail arm here. He's got this very like dread look to him, like he's just completely devoid of any emotion or morality, and he's just ready to stab someone in the back, which literally that's his calling card, is that he sneaks up on people and stabs people in the back, but apparently it gets the job done. Again, same kind of sculpt, and a couple of details different on him. He has this cool hyena tattoo and a different setup for his shin guards and his loincloth. And again, he's got the scale mail arm. He also comes with this huge shield. And the shields actually have straps on them. That's a nice touch. They don't have some weird little thing to hold on to. They have straps that they can slip the arm in. He comes with this helmet. It's very nice. Axe. And then this short sword, which I believe is called a gladius, if I'm not mistaken. And he also comes with an extra arm, in case you're not feeling the scale mail. Now, I will say, on my copy, this arm has all types of splotches and blotches of blue paint, which looks kind of unsightly a little bit. At first I thought it was just like a wash, like a to make him look like dirty or whatever, but that's like blue paint. So that's not, you know, probably not supposed to be there. Hopefully I can take some alcohol and just wipe it off, but just pointing it out. Next we have Medocus, or Medocus, nicknamed the Reaper, and he's a Thracian. In the Spartacus series, the lead character was from Thracia. So I don't know if this is trying to be like him or if they just are using the names that they used as far as like where people are from. City Annapolis, group Aquilinus. So the Reaper, again, very similar body type. In fact, same exact body type as far as like the sculpt and the proportions and all that. He does have a tattoo on his back with some Roman numerals going up to the number 5, I believe. So not sure what that means, but it looks cool. He's got the cool shoulder piece armor, loincloth. He's got this here, wrist armor. And he has some really cool looking shin guards, like lots of detail. Lots of impressions and paint, nice texture, it's really cool. He also has a little sheath here for his weaponry. and the scar on the face. Very good head sculpt. Again, all of these guys' head sculpts are awesome, honestly. Like, they're very, very good. So this particular guy, the Reaper, comes with this helmet. I believe this is the Myrmidon helmet. Very common gladiator attire. And then he also has a very cool shield. Very detailed, textured. Again, comes with the straps. And then these two swords. You got the hook sword. And then you have this curved sword. So, very nice accessories for the Reaper. Nice paint on these as well. So, as far as this line goes, I did a little bit of research. I looked on their Facebook page, and they have a whole bunch of stuff that they're planning to do. They're talking about Praetorian guards, like Roman soldiers, more gladiators. I seen like a guy with like an Aztec headdress. So this whoever is running this company, they have a lot of stuff in store, and they got a lot of stuff planned. And I'm excited to see what else they have, because these three figures are great. I know a lot of people that I've been looking at on social media kind of not happy about the somewhat high price point, the $55 to $60 price point per figure. I get it. But when you get them in hand, you'll see that this isn't like you're buying a Marvel Legend or a McFarlane Toys $20 figure. Like, these are worth more than $20. Are they worth $60? Maybe not, but, you know, it's a new company and they're trying to get their foot in the game, so I'm not really mad at it. I really wanted to make sure that they were good before I, you know, put out my money, and I'm happy with what I got, and I'm looking forward to more. So, I'm going to add some pictures, compare some Mythic Legions with these guys, and then we'll get out of here. All right, just a real quick FYI. If you happen to decide that you want to get these guys and you're on board, please, 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 please soak the joints in hot water before you start trying to force stuff. I did not break anything, but I was trying to get this thing into Devilfish's hand, and it literally couldn't do it. His hand is just too tight. The plastic on the hands it's real durable and it's nice and tough, but it doesn't bend very much. I'm gonna use the Reaper here and do a few size comparisons so that you can get an idea of how he stacks up with Mythic Legions. And then I'll throw in some other lines too, just so you can see size comparisons. Okay, here he is with Atlas the Conqueror. We have a Barbarian Builder next to the Reaper. And as you can see, they scale very good with Mythic Legions. It's literally about the same height as a 1.0 body. And pretty much the same girth. I mean, the Fight for Glory guy, his shoulders are a little bit wider. His legs, I don't know, it's pretty close. It's very close. So these will scale very well with your Mythic Legions. And here we are with some different Mythic Legion style bodies. On the left here, we have Gadriel. It's a female body, and that's a typical female body as far as a human. And she, you know, she's shorter, as she probably should be, but she still looks good with him. And then we have King Bromden Ironjaw, and he is a dwarf, and he looks good with the Reaper. I mean, these guys are perfect to add, you know, supplement your Mythic Legions, especially if you're looking for gladiator-type bodies, like guys with not a whole lot of armor on, with a lot of, with some skin showing, which that's what I was looking for. And you can't get a hold of the old school 1.0 guys because they're, you know, $300 on eBay. This is something that you might want to think about. We have here some 1.0 knight bodies. On the left, we have a regular Templar knight with a custom head, but it's about what size they are. And then we have Attila, the Ulcer, and he is, you know, 1.0 knight body, one of the iconic characters of Mythic Legions. Now for some other lines, we have Marvel Legends here, and we have the bigger Asgardian Olympian type bodies. We got Hercules, the Prince of Power, here on the left, and we have Thor, Odin's son, God of Thunder, on the right. Still looks good with those guys. Thor's a little bit taller, but Thor's supposed to be huge. They look good with the Marvel Legends as well, and they fit in good as far as aesthetic goes with your mythic or your medieval, your sword and shield type characters. And just for the heck of it, here is a comparison with the Purplore, which is another 1.0 body. And for anybody wondering, I don't actually own any 2.0 male bodies. The smaller, in stature, kind of skinnier body mold for Mythic Legions. Don't own any of those guys yet. And I don't have any ogres or anything like that, so I can't compare them to those, at least not yet. And then on the right here, we have a Masters of the Universe Classics figure. I do not know what that guy's name is. I bought him for a custom. This is Roman Reigns' face on Masters of the Universe. Yeah, looks pretty good. But again, he fits in well with your Masters of the Universe Classics as well. Okay, so final thoughts. This line is looking like it's going to be a winner, to be perfectly honest. This is not a Marvel Legends DC Multiverse quality figure. It's a step above that. Especially because its articulation is better than, like, say, a Mythic Legions. They have plans to come out with a whole lot more figures. And from what I've seen in the pictures, they look great. And if they're going to be anything like these guys, then sign me up. So that's my little unboxing of the Combatants Fight for Glory from XesRay or XesRay, or don't really know how you say it, Ray Company. And again, you can get these at, I got mine at Empire Toy Shop. You can also order them from 5K Toys. I don't know where else you can get them because I haven't seen them anywhere else besides like eBay. So, all right, let me know what you think. Like, subscribe, share.